I had a lot of fun printing and experimenting with the VJ24X, and that's something you'll want to do. Experiment with different ways to use these new colors. We can dramatically change the output of these prints by mixing up the way and order in which you apply the white and metallic. For instance, this design is printed on GMI High Stat Clear Static Cling with no white undercoat.
Now it looks good, but I see how the message could easily get lost or blend in with everything we can still see on the other side of the window.
Right. Now here's the same design on top of a white undercoat.
Yeah, see a clear difference. It stands out much better.
Which is the point, right? Now let's print this same design one more time, but with a metallic undercoat.
Oh, wow. Again, I don't know how well this translates via webcast video, but it almost has a pearlescent quality to it.
It really does. And it's more opaque. The metallic underbase serves the same function as the white layer. Now, since silver is not as bright as white, you will lose some saturation on the CMYK layer, but the overall pearlescent effect is really nice. Whether you're using a white backing or the metallic silver, you can also fine-tune the look by varying the ink limit of the channel that you use for the underbase.
Now, what do you mean by that?
Well, the LXI RIP 12 Production Manager has a color adjustment tab that allows you to adjust the ink limits. You can adjust them overall or by channel. This is a tool that's essential in ICC profiling, but not normally used in digital printing on a day-to-day basis. So with the earlier window graphic, we agreed that the white backing allowed the image to pop more than the version without the undercoat. But some may want a little less opaque underbase to preserve the translucent effect a little more, make it more easy to see through, or to reduce ink cost, and a little more translucent effect on the decal. If you want to shoot it for something like that, you might reduce the white ink limit to, say, 50%.
And we can do that with silver, too?
Yes. In fact, I think you'll seldom want to print with 100% silver undercoat. We found it to be so dense that it wasn't completely cured before laying down the CMYK layers. And so the colors blend together a little, leaving you with a little bit of a muddy look.
What percentage of metallic backing do you recommend?
Well, it's going to vary depending on the application and the look you're going for, but we printed this window cling with a silver metallic undercoat at about 30%.
Okay, and I suppose we need to show the difference between the spot process that we did a moment ago and the actual undercoat. So let's do that right now. This is a video that Jerry shot for us earlier this week.
So now we're going to look at how to print silver undercolor to get a nice pearlescent effect with your print. This graphic has already been designed, but what we have here is a nice elliptical graphic, and there are two key elements here in this particular design. The first is, of course, our underbase. We have a bottom layer that already has our nice metallic spot color fill, and this is the MML N1C1, or silver metallic. And on top of that, I have a gradient fill that has a transparency, because LXI does support transparency, so this is only a 55% opacity, and it's set to lighten. So when I print this, I'm going to get a layer of silver ink underneath this, and a nice variant or gradient with the color on top with some transparency, so the silver can shine through and give us a nice bright pearlescent effect. So I've already designed this, and I'm going to export that as an EPS, and we'll go over here to LXI, to the Production Manager, and click Add Job. And this is our silver undercolor. Right there it is. So with this particular file, what we need to do is set the ink limit. So I'm going to go to Job Properties. And we're also going to make sure that the panel is correct so we don't clip anything. Always a good idea to get the full graphic. The preset stays the same. The profile stays the same since we're still printing on a glossy vinyl. The metallic ink options will change because instead of printing spot color metallic, I'm now in my metallic channel printing under color. So we're going to select spot color or metallic under color, and then go to method underlay color on metallic, which is the opposite of what we did last time. So now we're doing an underlay instead of an overlay, and we have that selected as under color in the metallic channel. The other thing we want to do is we want to reduce the ink limit on the silver, because if we leave all these at 100%, what happens is your CMYK ink will still be wet, and your silver ink on the underbase will still be wet, and you'll get a little bit of a puddling effect. So we want to reduce the ink limit on the silver. So we go to the Color Adjustments tab, click All, and select the Spot Metallic channel, and we're just going to drag this down to about 40%. So that means that we're only going to get a 40% fill of silver metallic, and so when the CMYK ink is printed on top of that, it will be nice and dry, we'll get a nice clear sharp looking image, and we'll still have a nice pearlescent effect with the silver showing through underneath the CMYK values. And now we're ready to send that one. Let's give a little margin here. And there we go.
Okay, so that's the process of using your white or metallic as an undercoat. And again, a lot of control as far as what percentage you want to use.